Logistics for fires along Alaska's road corridors are occasionally similar to the lower 48. Be aware that there is a shortage of vendors in Alaska, and it is not uncommon for roadside fires to be run like remote fires. It takes a long time for supplies to get out to fires, so plan ahead and order early. To expedite orders for supplies and equipment, include catalog numbers along with the description and quantity needed with all orders. The Alaska Interagency Catalog of Fire Supplies and Equipment is available through the warehouse system. Alaska has large roadless areas. Aircraft or boats are often the only means of transportation for supplies and personnel. Alaska's waterways are frequently used, and when traveling by boat, life jackets are required. Fire operations in Alaska are often totally dependent on aircraft for movement of personnel and supplies. Distances create substantial 12 to 48 hour time lag in delivery of personnel and supplies. Helicopters are used extensively to deliver and retrieve fire personnel, crews, and supplies to provide operational support and to demob smoke jumpers and retrieve bearer cargo. In some areas, remote fuel sites will need to be set up to facilitate the use of aerial resources. With these remote sites, it is important to keep track and let people know if more fuel needs to be delivered. Nothing will shut operations down quicker than running out of fuel. Paracargo may be the most efficient method of delivery for remote fires. Retrieving PC requires expertise and ties up substantial helicopter time. If you are unfamiliar with PC, ask. Limit supply orders to the essentials, due to the expense of paracargo and aircraft cost, and remember that anything delivered must be retrieved. In boggy areas, log decks may need to be built for helicopters to land on. Use spruce logs and make sure that the deck is large enough and strong enough for the intended use. Rely on local expertise. Log decks should be uniform and well marked and taken apart and scattered when the helispot is no longer being used. Alaska staging areas are established at remote village airstrips to service multiple or large fires. Staging areas usually work for the area or zone and differ from the lower 48 standard. Instead of engines and heavy equipment, many have boats, aircraft, supplies for structure protection, and equipment to outfit EFF crews. Something to remember is that when equipment and supplies are no longer needed or in use, backhaul it. When backhauling, make sure supplies and equipment are secured and marked with the fire name and number. Any hazardous materials need to be marked and returned in approved containers. When in doubt on the handling of hazardous material coming in from the field, call the Alaska Fire Service Warehouse or the State Fire Warehouse for clarification.